Corey Barlog, director of God of War, has never been one to shy away from expressing his opinions against the notion that single-player games are supposedly dying. When EA made that moronic statement about how people don't enjoy single-player games as much as they did 5 or 10 years ago, Corey Barlog responded publicly on Twitter by stating, quote, "Oh dear God, EA, just utter nonsense." Corey wasn't just talking out of his ass either. He put his money where his mouth is with the triumphant launch of God of War, which not only garnered near universal acclaim from critics and gamers alike, but also became the fastest selling PS4 exclusive ever, selling a whopping 3.1 million units in a mere 3 days. Considering Uncharted 4 sold 2.7 million units in 1 week and still managed to sell 9 million units in its entire lifespan, suffice to say that God of War is well on its way to selling over 10 million units. It goes without saying that no matter what the likes of EA would like to claim, non-life service, linear, and/or single-player games are alive and well, and there is most certainly a place for them in the gaming industry. Now, recently, Corey Barlog participated in an interview with website IGN, during which he was inquired to elaborate further on what his thoughts are regarding claims that single-player games are dying. He began by stating, quote, "Single-player games are the phoenix at this point. We go through the ebb and flow. Games change by the different creatives that get involved and say, I have this crazy idea." Then, when talking about the popularity of Battle Royale games like Fortnite, he had this to say, "It doesn't necessarily mean that anything else goes away. It simply says that's the thing we're paying attention to. I don't want to work on any games that don't have some kind of story component because that is the draw for me. Competition doesn't drive me. It's not to say that competition is bad. It's not to say that competitive games are bad because I love that those exist, but it's not my thing." Finally, when discussing where single-player and multiplayer games stand in the video game medium, he said, quote, "It's not about a competition between multiplayer and single-player. It's not about any of them being alive or dead, right? It is Schrödinger's cat. We are alive and we are dead at the same time, right? And we will always be that way, and it will be an ebb and flow throughout time." I couldn't agree more with everything that Corey Barlog expressed in this interview. It is important to note that when I put single-player games on a pedestal, it isn't to discredit multiplayer games in any way. I believe that there is very much a place in video games for both types of games, and I wouldn't want one to be gone or overtake the other. It isn't about competing or saying which is better, as they both offer different experiences that will appeal to different people. But the reason I keep highlighting the success of single-player games is because game publishers like EA will have you believe otherwise for all the wrong reasons. They'll have you believe that there is no longer a place for single-player games in gaming, that abhorrent live services are the way of the future. As a result, we're seeing headlines like these popping up, declaring that AAA single-player games are dying and that this is fine. Let's set the record straight here. The only reason that EA is going so far out of their way to discredit single-player games is to justify their predatory practices. They're trying to sell us on the notion that they have to implement shady forms of microtransactions, that they have to shut down Visceral Star Wars game and repurpose it from a linear story-driven action-adventure single-player game to a live service by pushing the narrative that just making a great single-player game is no longer a viable endeavor. When what they really mean to say is that they wouldn't make as much money if they were just to make a great single-player game. For them, it's not about making enough money for the company to thrive. It is about making all the money in the world by any means necessary because they can. And by saying that single-player games are dying, they're attempting to dilute their blatant display of avarice in the eyes of the public, though it isn't working. Nobody's buying this bullshit. Corey Barlog is absolutely right. It is not about single-player and multiplayer trying to outdo each other. It is not about either of them being dead or alive. It is this ebb and flow throughout time. For every massively successful multiplayer game like Fortnite, there will be massively unsuccessful multiplayer games like Lawbreakers. For every massively successful single-player game like God of War, you're going to get your Mass Effect Andromedas. Time and again, it's been proven that if you put out a product that's fresh, compelling, appealing, consumer-friendly and high quality, if you put out a kick-ass game, consumers will flock towards it, plain and simple, regardless of genre or regardless of whether it's single player or multiplayer. Sure, in the long term, God of War may not end up making as much money as the likes of Battlefront 2 or Destiny 2 with their uncapped monetization, but they sure as hell will be remembered and hailed for generations to come, all while remaining financially prosperous in the long term as franchises like God of War continue to gain notoriety and recognition. And I don't know about you, but I'd be more proud of that than raking in hundreds of millions of short-term dollars from swindling consumers while discrediting a type of game that is beloved by many, that has thrived and will continue to thrive. With that, I would like to end this news update. Thank you for tuning in. If you enjoy my content, consider supporting me on Patreon. It is completely optional, but donating even as little as a dollar a month will go a long way in helping this channel grow. And to be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out!